Hi, I'm Dr. Schroder, and today we're going to talk about a common problem that we see in our office very frequently, and that's called a hernia. A hernia is a hole or defect in the abdominal wall through the muscle that allows tissue from inside the abdomen to bulge through it. This can be intestine or fatty tissue called omentum that bulges into the hole. There are three types of hernias. There is a reducible hernia, an incarcerated hernia, and a strangulated hernia. A reducible hernia is usually asymptomatic. It goes in and out of the bulge and is easily pushed back in by the patient or the provider examining the patient. A reducible hernia usually can be watched and treated expectantly. It usually does not require surgery. However, an incarcerated hernia is a hernia where the tissue bulges into the hole and gets stuck. This can be firm and tender and cause pain, and often makes a patient want to go to the emergency room or be seen by their family doctor or a surgeon. Not infrequently, if the hernia cannot be pushed back in and it stays incarcerated, it will require surgery. The third type of hernia is a strangulated hernia. A strangulated hernia is an incarcerated hernia or hernia that has tissue stuck in it that all of a sudden becomes painful, gets swollen, and the blood supply to the tissue stuck in that hernia gets cut off. That's a surgical emergency and needs to be seen immediately in the emergency room and taken to the operating room to be reduced and repaired. There are many types of hernias. The most common type of hernias found in the groin are called an inguinal hernia. Inguinal hernias can be direct or indirect, or they can be femoral. The most common is an inguinal hernia, either in the direct space or inguinal space, which can make up about 75% of all hernias. Femoral hernias are seen in women, usually after pregnancy or associated with weight. Inguinal hernias are seen more frequently in men, about 25 times more than women. And these usually are associated with lifting, strenuous activity, or the men can be born with these hernias. Another type of hernia is an umbilical hernia, and this is a hernia at the belly button. Often, patients are born with these and they develop and get bigger over time. Another type of hernia is an incisional hernia, and this occurs in a scar from a previous surgery. This can be due to infection at the surgical site. It can be due to returning to normal activities too early, such as heavy lifting and strenuous activity. Often these remain asymptomatic, but these too can become incarcerated or strangulated and need emergency surgery. Another type of hernia that we see is called a sports hernia, and this is actually one of my favorite to diagnose and treat. A sports hernia occurs in young athletes. This comes on as a result of heavy weightlifting, preparing for their sport, sudden acceleration, deceleration, and sharp turns. Sports hernias usually occur in the groin and can be associated with muscle tears that are associated with the sudden movements that the athlete makes. Often they're seen by the orthopedic surgeon and referred to us for evaluation. Another type of hernia that we'll talk about briefly is a hiatal hernia. A hiatal hernia is a hernia of the stomach that goes through the diaphragm into the chest. This often can cause reflux and heartburn and can be incapacitating at times. Normally, these can be treated with medicine and the patient will be asymptomatic, but not infrequently, these hernias can go up into the chest, get stuck, and cause obstructive symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, and inability for food to pass. In these cases, these should be evaluated and treated and surgically corrected.